Hello, I'm Sue Gillum, and I'm going to show you how I create a strip landscape on a board. Now, I want to show you some of the finished pictures, and then I'll get started creating one. Now, this is a 16 by 20, and in putting it up today, I've decided it needs working on some more. It needs some whites in here. I try to keep a sort of a zigzag pattern down through the picture. So we'll take that one away. I'm proud of this one. This is all somebody else's painted papers and then mine are through here. And again, I think I've created the sort of the zigzag pattern so that it keeps the eye moving through the picture. And here's one that's a little bit different. I've used lots of papers and some ribbons in this one. And then I've got two smaller ones. That's, again, all strip papers with obviously a center of interest right in the middle there, or to the side. I try to keep it off center. Sometimes I end up being in the center. And here's a small landscape. Again, just papers. And then when I've finished with the papers, I'll show you, then I work with pencils or paint or more papers just to tie it all together. Okay. Now I want to show you one that I did that I'm sort of going to copy when I do the next one. Again, trying to keep a line of interest all the way through. I start off with a board that is standard size. This is mat board, and then I mark in the image and where the mat will go on the outside. And then I paint both sides with acrylic medium. And this stops it from warping when it's finished. Now, then I get the papers out. You can see I have papers all over the place. And I usually start with sky, and I'll start with pictures from calendars or magazines that are commercial. They're not mine. And this you can see in the back here. And then I'll put some of my papers over the top to make it mine. And then I work down lights, darks, until I've got something that that works. And I try to keep a large area and some smaller areas. And again, try to have a center of interest or several points of interest. So now I'll get started creating a new one. I've torn some papers that just to save some time. And here's my papers from a magazine. So I'm creating a sky. And for a little bit of contrast, oh, I've got to glue those down before I put any more in. So the next step is this is acrylic medium that I'm using to glue papers down. So I spread the medium on the board and then enough of that, so we'll clear those off. I Christmas cloud. Oh, there it is. And I'll try to put it a little off center so that I don't have the center of interest right in the middle. And then the next layer will be some of my painted papers. Oh, I think we'll take that off. You can, whoops, put it on afterwards. Then this layer on the top so that to be careful to bring them down one layer at a time. It's hard to go back after I've got something down. Let's put him over this side this time. He's a little bit strong, but later on we can put some plain tissue over it to soften it, or paint. Okay, ooh, let's have some shocking stuff here. Creating these papers is so much fun. I'll show you how I do that later. Looks like this picture is going to end up with quite a large sky area. Yeah, if it doesn't fit, you just fold it. That's good. I've got that dark that comes down from the hill or sky or a cloud, whatever it turns out to be. As I work these, I'm really not quite sure what it's going to be, except that it's a landscape. And I'm obviously not copying that one because I have a hard time doing that. But that gives you an idea how it ends up. And I make sure I go over that line so that when we put the mat on, it's covering it all. So I've already created, maybe this is a river coming down there. Oops. Okay, now, looks in pale area. Some board and then put in Oh, there's a good piece. That's similar to the paper I used in that one. dug up this interesting paper at the old Emporium downtown, and it's somebody, I forget the name of the artist who painted it, but it just got me excited to be able to use it. And I checked, it's perfectly legitimate to use somebody else's papers. There's no copyright problem. Okay, I need some more of that to make it a bigger. Yes. Of that paper over here. Here's the big sheet that I bought. Isn't that beautiful? Yeah, we need some more. Well, I'm falling into my usual trap. The two sides are very similar, and so the center is the center of interest. But I think those are such interesting papers, it'll work. Now, I've got some. Some more pale area. Keep it pale until I get to the very bottom. Sort of pale. And if they're a little bit transparent, you can see the layers, see the layer underneath coming through. I usually take quite a bit more time deciding on what I'm going to put. But seeing as we're doing a demo, I don't want you to get bored. And some dark area along the bottom. Is that a little too strong? This piece, I had this little piece that fits right there, so that'll go. Maybe not. I planned for that to be in there, but it's not going to work. Oh, I know. I think I'll put that in there, and then I'll put some little bits of the paper up there to balance it.
I think that's too strong.
Ooh.
I think it needs to be a blue to balance the sky. So we'll see what I can find here. Out some of these before I glue them down, just to see what we've got. Maybe a little dash of that. Again, that right dead center, I need to move it off to the side. Okay, let's get some of this side papers down. Double that up to get a little extra interest. On one end so that I can put something underneath it. I think that's going to be enough of that dark. Fold it a little bit there to make it fit. And now, maybe more of that green. It up there and have a look at it and see what. Okay, I think I'll put a little bit of this dark one up here. Little strips can just go on the top. I think that's a good start. So now we'll have a look. I'll have a look at this one that is not finished, but this is what, how this one was. When it's dry, then I can work on it with paints or more papers, or I've got some pencils today. Aquarelle pencils, they're water soluble, so I can, they'll look like paint when they're on. So I need to have a, get some lines coming through it. So I think I'll darken that. fingers to blend that. Push that back so it makes it look a bit like a cliff. I should put that in the water. And, oh, I know what I was going to put on that one. Some little bits of, I'll go back to that one. This one I need to sit and study. Oh, I know what, I will work on this area to make the, if that's water, to make it lie down flat, which will mean bringing this out and cutting off that, maybe some okay. Had a thought of some of this that I want to put to create more interest. I said it's hard to go back to make it sit behind the front rocks, but with these multicolors it's easier. And let's see, we've been a bit on the other side somewhere. How about down here? Green. Along there. Oops. Yeah, now I would work on that some more when it dries. Now let me show you how I create some of these papers. When I've finished painting, I have paints on my palette. I'll just spread some on tonight. And this paper may eventually be used for a landscape. Okay, and this is palette paper, and so I spread the paint out on the palette and then put tissue over it and spray it with water and some more interesting effects come there. And then, oops, that's right, and then some medium. Okay, then I leave that to dry, and when it's dry, I can, this is a more of the same thing. You can just pull it, lift it back. If it tears, it doesn't matter, because it might get torn in the end anyway. So there's one, and here's another one. I think I'm gonna like this one. That's almost the start of a landscape right there. And then these are some of the papers that I have in my stash that have been created with this method. And some bright gold. And I think that's about it. We have two pictures with potential, and I have masses of paper and a few boards. If anyone would like to try it, call me 512-343-7268. And I could meet you in the art studio where we are right now and get you started. Maybe when things open up, we'll be able to have more classes. Thanks, everybody.